We're recording. Hi! You ready?
Yeah.
You sure?
No.
Welcome to Mass Movieside, the epic journey of a couple of film junkies and the movies they watch. This is a bonus episode. This is our second in our series of Oscar
correct
episodes. Yes. IMB, I'm joined by Jay. Jay, introduce yourself to YouTube and the podcast and the people and the
happy Jay.
This week we are watching Life of Pi, directed by Ang Lee and starring, get ready, Suraj Sharma, Irrfan Khan, Adil Hussain, and lots of other people.
Wasn't Gerard Depardieu?
Gerard Depardieu is in there, too. Okay.
I can pronounce his name. That's
and why. Gerard Depardieu was in there, too. Gerard Depardieu, too. Yeah, he was in there for a few seconds. If you want to talk to us, you can email us, massmovieside@gmail.com. You can find us on Facebook. Just search for Mass Movieside. Twitter, @massmovieside. I will tweet back, I promise. You know, talk to me, please. I'm lonely.
He's very lonely.
So lonely. And whatnot. You can send us requests, cookie recipes, all that kind of stuff. Yes. We like cookie recipes. Yes. One day, somebody's going to send us a cookie recipe, and we're going to document us like with aprons
making cookies.
If you send us something that we use on the show, we will send you a piece of Mass Movieside memorabilia. In particular, at the moment, we're giving away my childhood.
Yes.
You never know. You could get something like this this Stormtrooper, or you could get something like, I don't know, something like this Millennium Falcon!
Oh my god!
Ah! Yeah, so spoilers, and just to really drive that home, we're going to sound the Sieg from Norway, spoiler alert system by remote.
Well done.
Thank you. And there it is, you've been warned. Jay, what was the Life of Pi? What was Life of Pi? There's no the, and that's not the Facebook. What was Life of Pi all about?
The next part of the story you will find hard to believe.
About a man retelling a story of how he came over from India. His boat sank, and he got stuck in a boat with a tiger. Hijinks then ensue, and he almost gets eaten by an island.
That's pretty much it.
Yes,
that's a good. I'd put that on the back of the box in a heartbeat.
Yes, you had told me the other day. You asked me what I knew about this movie.
Yeah.
And I was like, it's got a tiger and a raft. Other than that, I don't know anything. And you're like, good. Don't look into it. So I didn't. Yeah. And I was pleasantly surprised because in my mind, the like tiger was like his buddy. And it was going to be like, oh boy, tiger, we're going to make it across. Like, that's not at all what this was.
No. This movie is so funny too because the reason, I saw this on Wednesday. I will say I loved it.
Okay.
Loved it. Good. Loved it, this movie.
Ooh.
Now, I have to say also, if you notice on our good friend here, he's wearing these 3D glasses. The 3D in this movie is amazing. I hate 3D.
Okay. But why did you choose it in 3D?
It was the only option available.
Okay.
And I'm glad that it was the only option available. This movie, for those of you out there listening right now, if this is still in theaters when you're listening to this, I'm telling you, go see it in 3D.
I saw it at my house.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you pirate you.
It was still good.
You bastard.
It was good.
Okay.
I want to.
And that's why you're not blown away. The visuals in this movie were un-be-fucking-leavable.
I agree.
Throughout.
Yes.
The island, the moment where he's in that area where everything's glowing, that whole thing.
Oh, with the whale?
Beautiful. Yeah, the whale. Yeah, exactly. All that stuff. The 3D really, really is the experience. The movie, and this I think is part of why it's not Best Picture of the Year. I'm going to go ahead and say that right now.
Okay.
The movie will suffer from not being seen in 3D.
Are you really going to do that now?
No, go for it. No, it's not working.
The first half hour of this movie is an introduction to his life, to the main character's life, and a discussion, really, of religion.
I didn't know how to take that.
Yeah, well, see, we, together, are not the most.
Are we coming out? We're coming out.
Sure.
We're both kind of not the most. Go ahead and finish it.
I will.
Yeah.
We're not the most religious people in the world. You less so than me, I think.
I'm a little more. I'm a little angrier about it.
You're aggressive about it.
There you go. Aggressive atheism.
I'm more of, you could do your thing, I'll do my thing.
So am I.
But you like to remind people sometimes that when they say something about God, they're stupid.
So it depends on the surroundings I'm in.
Sure.
It depends also the mood I'm in. Do I feel like picking a fight? I pick fights.
You do.
And it's solely for the purpose of picking fights.
Sure.
I don't expect to save anyone. I don't expect to convert anybody.
Maybe you will one day.
Maybe, but I'm not out to do that. I'm not out to convert. I'm just out to cause trouble.
I see. To be honest, I kind of like the way they approached it. I really like the way they approached it. The conversation that the father has with the son at the table.
Yes.
When he's just like, well, if you don't, you know, having all the faith is just as bad as no faith or whatever.
Yeah, I like the way he said, there was one line where he kind of finished it, where he said, I'd rather you disagree with my beliefs than just believe in anything blindly.
Right, right. You know, seeing it from that kid's eye, it's kind of like he was like, well, how do I know which is the right
one? Which was right, exactly.
And he kind of hedges his bet. I liked the way they kind of approached it, where there was nobody that was right, and this was kind of his belief system, and it was, he questioned it too, which was great, where he was like, why would your God do this way?
I like that. When he goes back to the church like a bunch of times, they dare him to drink the holy water.
Yeah. Is that holy water?
Yeah.
How do you know it's holy water? It's not just regular water.
It's holy water. He went to the little holy water.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
The priest walked in and gave him a glass of water.
After he drank the holy water. I know this.
Okay.
Have you ever drank holy water?
No.
It tastes like shit. You want to know why? Everyone dips their fucking hands in it when they leave the church or come into the church or bless themselves or kneel or sneeze. When you're a kid, you get dared to drink the holy water.
I see. Was it delicious?
It's gross. Every kid that's ever been to a Catholic school has drank holy water on a dare.
Yeah. Okay. So, and then you get to see that.
And they grow up to be atheists.
And then the movie takes a turn.
Takes a big turn.
They get on this boat with a bunch of assholes.
Well, they're on a boat of sailors. They're not on a cruise ship.
Right.
You know
it's
what I mean? They
ship.
Took the cheapest route possible. And this this storm comes along.
Mm-hmm.
And Pi wakes up in the middle of the night, hears a storm. And he walks out, and at this point, I yell, what an asshole!
Why?
Because he was being an asshole. Who the fuck, when you're out at sea, goes out onto the deck like that in the middle of a storm, in the middle of the night, without telling anyone? And then he's, like, partying and sliding around.
No, okay, fuck, he fucking lived.
That's a good point, I guess. My dad, last week, told me and my brother and sister how he wants to go on, like, a cruise this year. Fuck that. Fuck boats. Cruise my ass.
I was on a cruise that had a storm that was not as bad as that, but it was in the realm of that
could have been
storm.
Had I been on the boat, we'd have gotten down. It was so cool.
Yeah.
It was terrifying. I'll never get on a boat again.
So, at this point, he's made it onto the boat, and he sees his tiger friend. Not so much a friend at this point. It's his enemy still.
He's
terrified
of
him because he watched a goat get eaten by him.
Let's go back to that. Okay. So we're not at the boat yet. All
right, we're not at the boat. Hold on.
Pi is a little kid again. He's like 8 years old,
whatever
right?
It was, yeah.
And he goes down because they've got this new tiger, Richard Parker.
And he called him by his full name the whole time,
Richard Parker. So Richard Parker comes along, and Pi is going to feed him, like hand feed this tiger. And at the very last second, this zookeeper comes in and scares away Richard Parker. That fucking tiger, when it recoiled and ran,
because
I wasn't sure whether I had just watched a CGI tiger, which I did, or a real tiger, and they just scared it to make it run away.
It's 82% of the tiger is CGI.
It's unbelievable throughout the movie.
The only, the longest scene that you get, because there's a couple of little shots, but the longest scene you get, there are two, is the tiger swimming. That whole swimming sequence is an actual tiger.
An actual tiger.
And when
Which is amazing, because then you think that'd be the one they
right,
take.
Right, exactly. And then there's when he's training him with the stick.
Okay.
That's a real tiger, because he was like clawing into the wood and stuff like that. That was all real. Everything else... CGI. Everything else.
Un-be-fucking-leavable.
That was great.
If anything else, this movie deserves like an effects award for that.
I'm sure it will.
That I think is half the majesty of this movie.
If you had to choose between facing down a tiger, facing down a shark.
Well, the shark's got to stay in the water.
Correct.
So I think I'm going
to... But let's just say, you know, he knows the tiger's in the boat and he's in the water, and you get back in the boat. to face the tiger, or do you stay in the water and like kick the sharks a bunch of times?
You're gonna try and drown that tiger. See, and that's the thing is he didn't believe in killing.
Correct. Otherwise, that thing would be dead a long time ago.
His whole goal was to keep everything alive.
Right. I felt really bad for the orangutan when he died. It was really sad.
Because you were half expecting him to come along.
Right.
And like, it's the most human thing you've got other than
right.
Pi.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
It's going to be like, this is going to be our friend. And then, but you feel bad for the zebra that's like screaming or whatever.
Right. But
the orangutan has this
right.
Human
aspect. Like, tip his hat at you. The zebra's just like a horse. But
good morning, Pi.
That's the most human thing that I can think
hello,
of.
Hello, hello. This kid was not nominated for an Academy Award.
Really?
That's a shame. But I feel like this kid might have deserved something.
It was originally going to be Tobey Maguire, and they were going to...
Well, no, Tobey Maguire was the interviewer.
Oh, was the interviewer.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Was the writer.
I'd read Tobey Maguire was like one of the main guys.
No, he was going to be... It was they actually filmed it
okay.
with Tobey Maguire
really?
As the interviewer.
Okay.
And then Ang Lee went back and was like, I'd rather get somebody lesser known. And I don't pretend to have figured out the whole movie.
No.
By any means.
I don't think you're supposed to. I don't
no.
think...
It's very much interpretation, and it's very much... up to the viewer to fill in the
sure.
blanks a little bit.
But
I will say the performances are fantastic. Everybody, the father,
the guy,
young Pi,
the
great.
Kid or the guy in the boat is reacting to nothing the entire movie.
Right, yeah.
So,
and there's even, I mean, he has these, yeah, that's a great point. That's a fantastic point.
Yeah.
I didn't even think of that. That there's no actor opposite him. There's
nope,
no tiger.
Nothing.
It's just CGI.
Yep. Good.
I liked it a
yeah.
lot. I liked this movie a lot. But again, I think... Watching it at home on TV won't be the same experience.
Mm-hmm.
This movie. If you're out there right now and you can still see this in 3D in the theaters, do it. Only because I think it sails on visuals. This one.
Sure.
So, Life of Pi.
And again, we both saw it very recently, and we're both very
we're high on it.
Right.
Yeah.
So there's gonna come a time where we go. Well,
wait a minute. That wasn't that good.
Right.
Right.
We have a website.
We do.
It's massmovieside.com. We have an email,
yes.
massmovieside@gmail.com. We are Facebook, Twitter, and iTunes, and Stitcher, and YouTube.
Damn right.
Just search Mass Movie Side. Go to iTunes, leave us a review, and subscribe absolutely for free.
Mm-hmm. Tweet, and we'll talk back. We'll tweet
yes.
back. We tweet back. We tweet.
This is the second or one of our 9 Oscar movies.
Yep.
Expect to see at least 7 more.
Yeah. We'll get through them all.
Thanks for listening.
End the podcast so unceremoniously.